Welcome back. Beginning this month, the Internal Revenue Service will begin to outsource delinquent accounts to private debt collectors to acquire unpaid tax liabilities. Ken, do you think this is a good idea?
I've got mixed thoughts on it. It would depend on how it would work. All right. I am a huge fan of government contracting. I firmly believe that contractors to the federal government can typically do things more efficiently than the federal employees typically can because they have specialized skill sets. So with that said, I'm going to say it depends how it would be set up. Correct me if I'm wrong on this. My understanding that typically a debt collector, the way that it works is they're given the debt, and if they can collect that debt, they get to keep a percentage of that debt.
Yeah, right? In this case, 25.
I would be very concerned about that just because that's going to open up to a lot of abuse with very aggressive debt collectors.
Oh, yes.
I really don't see that being good.
Yeah.
Now, if it was a flat rate of, hey, we're going to hire X number of contractors to go ahead and do the debt collection the same way the IRS is already doing it, that I could see possibly working.
So I have a really crazy idea. Rather than doing this whole rigmarole and adding a whole nother layer of creating another industry that can leech off the way the inefficiency of the system that we have, how about we restructure our tax code to where you pay a certain percentage of your income and it comes out of your paycheck, and we no longer have April 15th. It just is what you pay and it's done, and there's none of this other craziness that goes into it.
So I'm going to build off of that and say, prior to, I believe it was 1913, we didn't even have a permanent income tax. So why are we taxing people on trying to live? Why are we taxing them on their income? Why don't we do a consumption-based tax instead, based upon what they spend?
A VAT? A value add?
I would actually be okay with a VAT if we eliminate income tax.
Yeah, well, that's another whole issue.
I think that there are a lot of different ways of doing this. Yeah, my entire point, however, is we are, and I have family that lives all over the world, we are the only country that goes through this ridiculous April 15th rigmarole that we go through. Everybody else either, has an income tax or they pay a consumption tax or whatever, but that's it. They're done. You eliminate so much bureaucracy in not having to maintain this.
There goes the unemployment rate when you put all the accountants and all the other people out of business. But you're
absolutely
right.
This is extra business.
This is a job
here.
Program.
But they did this already. There was a pilot program.
As an opportunity to retrain these people in areas where they could become more interesting. Have social skills.
Less hated by the public.
Yeah. Well, yeah. I mean, this wouldn't help that at all, I don't think. But they did have a pilot program for 3 years, which they discontinued in 2009 because it was basically a failure. And it turned out they were losing more money in the end, the actual balance, because what happens is when you get the private tax collectors, they go over after the low-hanging fruit.
Right.
So they go over what they can, and also they are not required, and in this case they weren't. The IRS itself will take into account people's economic needs and try to work something out.
Right.
These people don't have that same thing. And I was looking up some historical stuff. Do you know one of the reasons the Roman Empire ended?
Aside from the fact that the church established dioceses that overtaxed on top of the imperial tax,
well,
and
yes,
bankrupted
but it was also,
the military.
No, but it was also because of they privatized their tax collections and created a whole massive, because of the corruption.
They also privatized their military and brought in a bunch of mercenaries that happened to be Germanic.
This is what happened
tribes
to the Roman Empire, and we want to go down the same road. Sometimes it's good to look at history, and I'd be very loath to do it. I don't see any upside, really, in doing this sort of thing.
I think you bring up a very good point, because inadvertently is going to happen. Private tax collectors are not going to go after a Donald Trump-type character
that
has not paid, because they have the lawyers to fight back.
Right. Yes.
They're going to go after the small business person who underpaid their taxes because, guess what, you know, their kids had some health issues or something else, and they just could not float.
Or a big corporation has moved into town and is trying to get them out of business.
Right, and next thing you know, you have some private tax collector that's going after that guy because they're going to be the easy target.
It's easy to target. Which, see, and that, it turns out, again, see, this is where, you know, even these ideas of just flat rate, whatever, it doesn't necessarily work.
I think it would be easier
to
manage.
You end up penalizing the little guy in the end on a lot of these kind of things.
Well, that's where consumption tax hopefully.
Well, the consumption tax does it even worse, because the percentage, you know, whatever you consume, it's huge for the amount of money you have as a person who can't even put money in the bank.
Well, it depends on what you're taxing. I mean, you don't have to have a consumption tax on everything. For example,
our
state sales tax does not apply to food.
Right.
Which is good. Yes, so, but what are you talking about, though, then?
What I'm saying is, you tax it just like state sales tax. Tax anything that isn't bare essential.
So I think there's two good points here. One is Tom's and one is yours. The first one that Tom is making is the fact that as a percentage of their pay, somebody who's a multi-billionaire doesn't eat anymore. They don't buy any more clothes.
They invest.
So you have to figure out a way that is fair in that you're taxing based on income somehow, understanding that the consumption does not necessarily go as much. So are you then taxing investments? What else are you taxing?
Right.
And I think your point is very good in that, you know, we do have already some things in place to protect basic living things.
Right. Yes, protection. But it's not working too well at the moment for a lot of people, as we know, because they can't save money. There's some very big economic issues here. In an economy like the United States, a consumer's economy cannot be driven by a few billionaires. It's driven by the people who go to the stores and to that little business down the street and spend money. If they don't have it in their pockets, you've got a problem.
It's driven by that thing that is going the way of the dodo called the middle class.
Yes. Okay, well, I think that's it for now for this segment. Up next, Fast Five. Stay tuned.